Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we are going to look at the most underused feature inside of Power BI, at least from my perspective. Let's have a look. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, a little bit of context here. I may be a little biased based on the questions that I get and the work that I do, but in my conversations, usually people complain about performance. And when we're talking with those users and the report creators, when they talk to their users, the users are complaining that things are just slow, and that's why they're not happy. And so first off, I would challenge you, if you are creating Power BI reports, go talk to the people using the report and ask them what they think. A lot of times what I find is people who are creating the reports think that their report is amazing, and then they find out that, they don't actually think the same thing, the end users, right? They think it's slow. They think there's, all right. Anyway, enough of all this talking. You know we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my computer. First off, you see this page intentionally left blank. If you want to learn more about what this is, go check out a video I did on why I use a blank page. You can check up above in the corner or down in the description below for more info. All right, so first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over to View, and I'm gonna use the feature that is the most underused, and that is Performance Analyzer. Why would I say that's the most underused? There's so many great features inside of Power BI, and that's why people get caught up in all the cool shiny features of Power BI that are really great, but they don't stop and think before they publish to see how is it actually running, what's the user experience going to be. So I'm going to go and start recording. It's important to do that before I go hit the page. I'm going to hit my blazing fast report, which of course means that this is running fast, and we go in and that came up pretty fast. I think that's fast. It's not fast. It's not fast at all. The cool thing about this is you can actually see the timings here, and everything's over a second here. And if we sort, we can sort by DAX. And then if we sort by descending, you will see the slowest DAX item will always come up front. I always recommend starting here because usually the issue is going to be DAX or your data model. So always start here with the data. And then when you expand these items, you can see how much time the DAX query actually took. In this case, over 2 seconds. This is in milliseconds, right? That is forever in Power BI. This should be sub-second. My general guideline here is that if it's over 120 milliseconds, you heard that right, 120 milliseconds, there are things that you can do to make this go faster, potentially. And that's for each visual. Do this for each visual. And remember, go check out why I use a blank page to learn about the caching that comes into play so you understand that concept. But once you do, and you can understand what's going on here, you're gonna use tools like DAX Studio, you're gonna use other items to help you optimize your data model and your DAX. The more complicated your DAX is, chances are that your data model is probably not in the best of shape. So you wanna get that short up. So DAX is where you wanna go look at this DAX query. Like I said, 120 milliseconds. The other thing you'll look at then after that is visual display. How long did this actually take to render the visual? So this should usually be pretty quick. If you're seeing large buckets here, so like this one, 19 compared to 138, those should be fairly quick, but if they are bigger, then think about what are you doing in that visual? What's all included in there? How complex is it? Those are things to take into consideration. This is like a train, right? So these things have to go in order. Some of them get issued parallelly, but others will have to wait depending on how many visuals you have. So if you see a large amount of time inside of other, then the thing that you need to be looking at is how many visuals do I have on my page? Can I reduce the number of visuals? You know, a text visual, an image visual, a slicer, these are all visuals in your canvas. So how many do I have on that page? How many can I reduce to make this go faster? So less is more in this case. Usually you don't wanna have like 60 visuals on the report canvas. It's just not gonna be a good end user experience. The only way you get this insight is to start with Performance Analyzer. That's what's gonna lead you in a direction of where to go to make this better, whether that's the DAX, whether that's data modeling, whether it's visual reduction. Talk to your end users and make sure they're giving you the right information so that you can go make this a better experience. All right, I wanna hand this over to you. What do you feel feels the most underused feature of Power BI. Do you agree with me that, I've never actually used Performance Analyzer before? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.